Owning a decent laptop is beneficial when it comes to productively spending your time on the go, by, for example, working, gaming, or watching your favorite web video creator. The only problem is the limited runtime of the laptop's built-in battery pack, which normally gets charged up through the included laptop power supply, which is fueled by mains voltage. So to charge slash power the laptop on the go, I got the idea of creating a portable battery pack, which we can charge up through the laptop power supply and later use it to give the laptop an additional runtime of around 3 hours. The process of creating such a laptop power bank with all the required voltage levels and safety features was not that simple though. So sit back and enjoy my take on creating such a portable laptop battery pack. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, the most popular PCB prototype company in China, which produces more than 400,000 square meters of PCBs per month. So upload your Gerber files today to try out their PCB service for only $2. To start off, I had to collect some data. The built-in battery pack of my laptop stated a voltage rating of 11.1 volt DC and a capacity of 4,400 milliamp hours. So an energy of around 49 watt-hours. The laptop itself states an input voltage of 19.5 volts with a maximum current draw of 6.15 amps, which also correlates with the ratings of the laptop power supply. To test this, I plugged in a 5.5 by 2.5 mm DC jack into the laptop and connected it to a lab bench power supply set to 19.5 volts DC. And sure enough, the laptop's battery pack started charging, and while simultaneously running a benchmark, it drew a maximum of close to 5 amps. So 19.5 volts and a maximum of 6.15 amps should be the output characteristic of our laptop power bank. What is also important, safety-wise, is how much the supply voltage for the laptop can vary. Now, since I did not feel like frying my laptop with overvoltage, I rather disconnected the power and started removing a few dozens of screws in order to find out how the DC jack voltage is connected to the PCB ICs. But even after removing the SSD as well as the cooling system, I was not able to get to the DC jack. What I was able to figure out though was that the input voltage is directly connected to this connector, whose closest ICs were this BQ737 and this TPS51211. The BQ737 is a 1-4 cell lithium battery charge controller, which is obviously used to charge up the 3S lithium ion laptop battery pack. The IC features a maximum recommended voltage of 24 volts, which gives us some space to play around, but we should keep in mind that the datasheet also states that a voltage spike beyond the VCC voltage can destroy the IC. Now the other IC, known as the TPS51211, is a step-down controller for notebooks, which creates a smaller voltage for the laptop components. What a coincidence. This one even offers an input voltage of up to 28 volts, so even more space to make mistakes. With this knowledge, we basically learned that 19.5 volts would be great, but does not have to be spot on. Just like the power supply of the laptop does not exactly deliver this value. So after reassembling my laptop, which was only a bit tedious, I tested whether it still worked correctly, which it did, and grabbed my e-bike battery pack from a previous video. It consists of 13 lithium-ion cells in series, with 2 cells in parallel each, but feel free to watch the video about it in order to find out its specifications, how I build it, and why I do not use it for my e-bike anymore, and thus can repurpose it for this project. The only problem is that 13 cells in series is not only a bit too big, but also comes with quite a high voltage. As a solution, I desoldered the thick positive and negative battery wires, as well as all the balance wires, and cut the battery pack at the 8-cell series connection. This way, my new pack got a maximum voltage of 33.6 volts, a nominal voltage of 28.8 volts, and a minimum voltage of 20 volts at 2.5 volts per cell. Also, the pack can continuously deliver 40 amps and features a capacity of 5 amp hours, which equals a nominal energy of 144 watt hours. Thus, by assuming a conversion efficiency of 70%, we should be able to charge up the laptop battery pack up to 2 times, which should give us 3 more hours of laptop runtime. Awesome! The next component for the power bank is this BMS circuit, also known as a battery management system. This circuit adds an overcurrent, overcharge and overdischarge protection to the battery pack, as well as a cell balancing feature, which is pretty much mandatory for multi-cell battery packs. So, after soldering its included balance wires to the battery pack, as well as new power wires, and plugging in the connector, we got a predicted output voltage, which is mandatory for the next component, a powerful buck converter that can output up to 8 amps. After hooking it up and flipping its power switch, I adjusted its output voltage to 19.5 volts and set its current limit to the highest value. Through a DC terminal, I then connected this output voltage to the laptop, which, as you can see, charged the laptop's integrated battery just fine. Even higher amperage values are no problem for the setup, whose heatsink stayed pretty cool during all the tests. And most importantly, during switching on or off the buck converter, it did not create any kind of voltage spikes, which would be harmful for the laptop's circuitry. Next, in order to check when the power bank is completely dry, I also added a LiPo voltage tester to the battery pack, for which I desoldered its buzzers, hooked up a second pair of 8 balance wires, and connected them all to a male header to easily connect them to the LiPo voltage tester. Now we can see the voltage of each cell and basically disconnect the battery at a cell voltage of 3 volts. Last but not least, we need to charge up the battery, for which I got myself this powerful boost converter, which can output up to 60 volts and 12 amps. It is important though that it also features a constant current, constant voltage mode. To use it, I firstly connected the output of the laptop power supply to the input of the boost converter and set its output voltage to 33.6 volts, which is 8 times the recommended charging voltage of 4.2 volts. After then turning the constant current potentiometer to its minimum value and hooking up the boost converter's output to the battery pack in series to my multimeter in current measuring modes, I then adjusted the constant current limit to 2.5 amps, which is 2 times the recommended charging current of 1 cell, since we got 2 of them in parallel. And as you can see by observing the rising voltage of the battery pack as well as the constant current, we are charging the battery properly with the CC-CV charging method. To later easily check this charging process, I also added a voltage slash current monitor circuit to the output side of the boost converter. And after doing a couple of tests, this setup seems to work surprisingly well. So I created a suitable enclosure for the new battery pack, as well as all the complementary components in 123D design, and 3D printed it afterwards. Once the 22-hour printing session was complete, I combined the 2 parts of the enclosure and the lid with a bit of glue and moved on by mounting the switches and DC jacks. And since I messed up while measuring the height of the LiPo voltage tester, I had to shorten its PCB a bit before I could glue it into position. Afterwards, I used hot glue to secure the battery pack inside the enclosure, did some cable management, and moved on by wiring all the DC jacks, switches and buck boost converters to one another. Of course, explaining the wiring through words can be pretty confusing. So if you plan to build something similar, you can find a wiring scheme for this project, as well as pictures and additional information, as always in the video description. Now, as soon as I secured the boost and buck converter to the enclosure with M3 screws, I added the lid to the project, created a connection wire for my laptop, and did a final test by charging up the laptop power bank and afterwards using it to power my laptop, which both worked flawlessly. And with that being said, I declare this project a success, and I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. If so, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!